Hello, it's Bekah and welcome to the Carriage House. I'm in my kitchen today making a comforting southern-style cornbread dressing with sweet Vidalia onion, dried sage, rosemary, and thyme. Perfect for Thanksgiving and the upcoming holidays. So I'm very glad you're here and excited to share our family recipe with you. So I'm going to first start out by making the cornbread. So for the dry ingredients, I have 1 cup of cornmeal and 1 cup of all-purpose flour combined in this cup here. And I'm using King Arthur's gluten-free flour, and it turns out wonderfully, but you can use regular flour as well. And then I'm adding 2 teaspoons of baking powder, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, and 1 teaspoon of salt. Then I'm going to combine all these ingredients together. Now, normally, if I were going to make this cornbread alone with like a pot of chili or alongside another dish of some kind, I would add a little bit of sugar, creamed corn, and diced green chilies, and it is so delicious. But that recipe version is a little too moist for dressing. So I'm kind of wanting my cornbread to be on the drier side. So I've omitted those other things, but I'll try to share that other cornbread recipe with you another time. Okay, so moving on to the wet ingredients. I'm gonna need 1 cup of sour cream. You can also use buttermilk as well. 2 large eggs, 1/4 cup of melted butter that's been cooled first. You don't wanna scramble your eggs. Now, if you're using full-fat sour cream instead of light sour cream, then you may need to just add a little bit of water to thin it out. Sometimes the full-fat sour creams and things, they're a little too thick. So if your batter seems a little too thick to pour into your pan or your cast iron skillet I have right here, then just add a little bit of water just to thin it out. And again, I love baking cornbread in a cast iron skillet. So if you have one, then definitely use it, but you can use any baking dish or a muffin tin if you have one of those. Then you're going to smooth the batter into your pan, which needs to be lightly greased. I like to put 1 tablespoon of butter into my cast iron skillet and warm the pan along with the butter in a preheated oven for about 5 minutes, and then pour the batter in afterwards, and this gets a nice, beautiful golden crust on your cornbread. Okay, but either way, you're going to take your cornbread and cook at 400 degrees for approximately 20 minutes. In the meantime, I'm going to prepare the other ingredients for the dressing. So I have 1 large sweet Vidalia onion, or any sweet type of onion, or any regular onion for that matter would work just fine. But I'm really excited. I'm going to be decorating my kitchen this afternoon for Christmas. So the next video will be a cozy and comforting Christmas kitchen decorating video. So that should be posted early this week. I always say this, but you can click the notification bell to be notified when this video will be posted if you're interested. I'm also trying to post a homeschool video too on our other channel, which I haven't posted in a really long time. So I'm hoping to get that out as well. Okay, so now I'm going to saute the onion in a pan with about 2 tablespoons of olive oil, just enough to coat the bottom of the pan over about medium heat or so. I love to season as I go, so I'm going to add a little bit of salt and pepper, just a pinch of both. And I'm also going to add 2 cups of chopped celery and 2 cups of green bell pepper. Now, if you're making this during Christmas time, then I bet using a red bell pepper instead, or you can use 1 cup of red and 1 cup of green. That would be really beautiful and make it really festive looking. So I'm going to let all this cook for about 15 minutes until the vegetables are nicely soft and golden brown. And in the meantime, I'm going to switch my focus to the cornbread. So in a large bowl, I'm going to add 4 cups of chicken broth, 1 cup of heavy cream, 1 cup of milk, and 2 large eggs, and going to whisk this all together. And then I'm going to add the dry cornbread to the mixture, just breaking up the pieces with a wooden spoon and stir until combined. And then I will need to cover and refrigerate this all for 1 hour. So now I'm ready to add herbs and garlic to the pan. I'm using our sage, rosemary, and thyme that we harvested a while back that we've been drying over time for about a month or so. But I would say I'm using about 4 teaspoons total of dried herbs. You can use a combination of different types of herbs like I'm doing. So going to add 4 cloves of fresh chopped garlic, and I also add more salt and pepper. Overall, there's about 1 teaspoon total of salt in the pot and just a few pinches of pepper. And then after the mixture has cooled for about 5 minutes, I'm going to add it to the cornbread mixture that was sitting in the fridge for an hour, so it thickened up a little, which is good, and going to bake this at 400 degrees for about 40 minutes. It shouldn't be too runny, but it should be very moist, so kind of in between. So I hope you end up trying this recipe out. Let me know how it turns out if you do. I would love to know what your favorite Thanksgiving dishes are. You can share those in the comment section below. And thank you so much for watching and wishing everyone well and happy Thanksgiving. Bye.